State Republicans have their eyes on the prize. They're hoping for big gains in this year's midterm elections and beyond. Today on Upfront, Minnesota Governor Tim Pawlenty. Will he run for president in 2012?
It's pretty clear the public is moving away from Democrats more towards, you know, a message of lower taxes, limited government, lower spending, trying to get deficits under control.
Then Wisconsin's 7th congressional district, the seat David Obey has held for 40 years. It's suddenly a hot contest. This week on Upfront, the young conservative candidate drawing national attention.
And now that Dave Obey's gone, the challenges and the issues that we face in Washington aren't gone with him. They're still there.
And Democratic gubernatorial candidate Tom Barrett unveils his plan to put Wisconsin back to work.
Creating, retaining, and attracting jobs in the state of Wisconsin is job number one for me.
It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gousha.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. We've got plenty of politics on tap today. Wisconsin Republicans firing up the base at their state convention in Milwaukee this weekend. Attendance for the convention is up dramatically from a year ago. A reflection of new optimism in the grand old party that only 18 months ago was still a bit down in the dumps. Republicans have been shut out of power for several years now in Wisconsin, but many think 2010 is their year to capture the governor's office and possibly control of a state legislature, maybe even a U.S. Senate seat. Some are even looking beyond 2010 to 2012. Today on Upfront, we're taking full advantage of the big-name Republicans in our backyard. And yes, Democrats, hold your fire. We'll do the same when the state Dems hold their convention next month. But we begin today with Minnesota Governor Tim Pawlenty, one of the convention's featured speakers and a possible 2012 presidential candidate. Tim Pawlenty, thanks very much for being with us today.
Delighted to be with you, Mike. Thanks for having me on the show.
Governor, I have to ask you, you appear to be a candidate. You're doing all the things that a prospective candidate for president in 2012 would do, but is there anything that would keep you from running?
Well, let me say first, we need to stay focused on 2010. We've got 37 governorships up for election this fall all across the country. Congressional races that are really important. So my focus is trying to influence the 2010 elections. And as to 2012 and what I may be doing in politics or outside of politics, I'm going to decide that next year. But first things first.
We have some pretty bold predictions about how Republicans will do in the midterms. What's your assessment? How does it look?
Well, I think Republicans are going to do very well. It's pretty clear the public is moving away from Democrats more towards, you know, a message of lower taxes, limited government, lower spending, trying to get deficits under control. Those are themes that tend to favor Republicans pretty strongly. Pretty clear the public's moving in that direction compared to 2008. But we don't want to be overconfident. A lot of this is how much work are you willing to do, shoe leather and voter contact and the like. So we'll do well, but I think we need to make sure we also finish the job and close the sale.
A lot has been written and said about the elections of the past week, and I want to spend just a couple of moments on what happened in Kentucky, where people say that the Tea Party movement spoke and spoke loudly by making sure that Rand Paul won the Republican primary there. Are you comfortable with the Republican Party embracing the Tea Party movement, wrapping its arms around it? Are you comfortable with people like Rand Paul carrying the torch for the Republican Party?
Well, as to the Tea Party movement broadly, I think it's a helpful movement. It's new energy, new people, new ideas, new leadership, and it's a voice that's saying, you know what, we've got to remember the values and principles the country was founded on. And so they're trying to bring back kind of a constitutional perspective. I don't know Rand Paul. I know he made some comments the other day that I think were unfortunate regarding the Civil Rights Act. And I think he's tried to apologize or explain that. But setting that aside and just focusing on the rest of the Tea Party movement, I think by and large it has been a positive force in terms of the discussion and the energy it brings to the table.
You said in your conversations with people in Minnesota, for example, they're fed up. They're tired. They're angry. What are you hearing?
I'm hearing that people have figured out that this out of control spending in Minnesota's case. Look, from the time I was born until I became governor, the average 2-year increase in our budget was 21% for 40 years. I mean, Mike, that math just doesn't work. You can't have spending graph lines that look like that and revenue lines that look like that. An eighth grader can figure that out. People are seeing it in Greece. They're seeing it in California. And I think they're saying, look, enough is enough. We've got to get this thing under control. That's why they're swinging back towards candidates and messages that are saying limited government, focused government, keep a lid on taxes, try to encourage job growth. Minnesota, by the way, we just announced earlier this week that our unemployment rate dropped to 7.2% compared to a national average of nearly 10%. That's the biggest gap between Minnesota and the nation to the favorable side of the ledger since the 1970s.
So you have a policy record, and And I go back to an article I think I saw in the Washington Post earlier in the month. Michael Gerson, who used to be a speechwriter for President Bush, he's a well-known conservative policy guy. The headline is, and any Republican would probably like this headline, Tim Pawlenty, Minnesota's Ronald Reagan. Question mark. There is a question mark, I should say that. But his point was that you have a policy record, you have a record of success as a conservative in a fairly liberal state, but he wonders if you aren't a little too nice for the times we live in today. And I was struck by this quote in this, and I just read it for a moment. There are drawbacks to being a nice guy in an angry time. No Tea Party activist will find Pawlenty the most enraged voice. His attempts at stump speech outrage come across like a Baptist trying to swear. The words are right, but the melody is lacking, which raises the question. In a party of the incensed, can Pawlenty win the nomination without sacrificing his authenticity? What do you say when you hear that you're too nice for the times?
Well, we're Midwestern in Wisconsin and Minnesota, so we have a Midwestern outlook and disposition. But, you know, look, there is room and should be room in the debate for anger and outrage and the like. But in the end, particularly when people are looking for significant leaders as governors, president, or other significant positions, I think they want strong leaders. They also want hopeful and optimistic and positive leaders. You know, there's a lot of great voices who come onto the scene and are angry, but in the end, I think people are looking for that to be channeled into not just being the critics in chief, not just being the complainers in chief, but people who are willing to chart a positive, hopeful, optimistic course. And so I think that's something I can bring to the table, and it's a little different style, but I would match my record, you know, setting aside the rhetoric. You want to talk about not the rhetoric, but the record of results to anybody's in the country.
I think in that same article, though, you acknowledge that maybe 75% of Republicans really weren't familiar with you.
Yeah,
how do you overcome that?
Well, you know, and again, I'm here to try to help in 2010. That's what I'm doing in Wisconsin this week. But you know, I'll just get out and make sure that people understand what candidates we're supporting. But I'm not the best known candidate, but name ID and familiarity is something you can increase over time. And if I run or down the road politically, I'll do that.
A couple of quick questions on the issues of the day. Wall Street reform, it seems that Congress is moving closer to a final bill, probably this summer sometime. Some Republicans don't like what they see in this bill. Is it an overreach by government, or is it something we absolutely have to have, given what occurred 2 years ago?
Well, I think there's some elements in it that are good, but frankly, it's misguided in a number of respects. One of the things that I think people are fed up with is the bailouts. We need to have a rule that says no more bailouts, and we need to be able to, in an orderly way, unwind these large investment holding firms in the nature of a bankruptcy so we don't have to bail them out. We also need to do a number of other things. I would privatize, by the way, Fannie and Freddie, these government-owned, government-run mortgage entities. The fact that those are now basically government-controlled entities is ridiculous. We need to have a centralized clearinghouse for derivatives and various other exotic financial instruments, so there's some transparency about what's happening and there's some predictability about the stability of those. Those are a few ideas. So the bill that is put forward, I don't think in some ways goes deep enough in terms of getting at one of the main problems, which is we're going to end bailouts.
Immigration, Arizona's controversial immigration law. Sarah Palin said the other day that other states along the border should do exactly as Arizona has done. What do you think?
Well, Minnesota is a state that has sent National Guard troops to the Arizona border to reinforce border enforcement through Operation Jumpstart. It worked. We need stronger border enforcement, and we also need stronger enforcement. I think this Arizona law has been mischaracterized, Mike, a little bit in the press. People are saying it's going to allow police to just stop people for any reason. No, it doesn't. They have to have a probable cause for the initial stop, and then additionally, they have to have probable cause or reasonable suspicion that somebody is there illegally before they can inquire. And I think, you know, as long as you got a reasonable inquiry or a reasonable basis for the stop, checking on somebody's immigration status is okay. I don't think we should be afraid of that.
You're stepping down after two terms, as is Wisconsin Governor Jim Doyle. Were you surprised that Governor Doyle decided to end his career?
A little bit. You know, notwithstanding our political differences on some policy matters, I got to know Governor Doyle very well. We became friends. I like him. We get along. And I was thinking he was going to run for a third term, and then he made a difficult decision not to do it. And I know it was a close call for him. But again, I think he's a decent, good person. And again, notwithstanding our political difference, I really enjoyed working with him. Always found him as somebody who's civil, thoughtful, decent, constructive, and trying to find solutions to problems.
Minnesota Governor Tim Pawlenty, we appreciate your time today. Thanks very much
for being
with us.
Thanks for having me on the show.
The convention endorsed Milwaukee County Executive Scott Walker for governor this weekend. That after the other major Republican candidate, former Congressman Mark Newman, removed himself from the endorsement process and called on the convention not to endorse at all. WisPolitics.com has been live blogging the convention and has conducted a straw poll on the endorsement process itself. You'll find poll results and complete convention coverage on the website at WisPolitics.com. Next on Upfront, another Republican hopeful courting support at the state convention. Reality TV star turned district attorney turned congressional candidate Sean Duffy in a race that no one predicted. And the governor's veto spoiled their plans. What's next for raw milk supporters when Upfront continues?
Upfront with Mike Gousha, winner of the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association Award for Best Special Interest Programming. We'll be right back.